Good day to everyone. There's a major concern which is prevailing in the education industry at present, that is school fees. There are government, public, private, aided, unaided, and international school in India. We have our host today, Keezer Technologies Private Limited, and Mr. Keezer Ahmed, he is the director of Keezer Technologies, who has given us this golden opportunity to spread the message all over the world to ensure that we request parents and the school managements to take some steps to help our teachers' fraternity. Now, today's topic that we are going to talk about and give you a message is, how do we solve the school fee collection issue during this time and the impact on teaching staff? This is the topic for the day and a message to the society. Most of the private, unaided, public, and international schools are all running solely on fees paid by students. I mean, fees paid by the parents. The schools are facing trouble. They're into a lot of troubles. During this COVID-19 lockdown, circulars were sent asking the schools to stop fee collection. And the COVID-19 pandemic has definitely given the mankind a lot of positiveness and a good learning of life. And also, it has given mankind several challenges. This has also led to the indefinite closure of educational institutions across the country without any time frame on the resumption of classroom academics. There were many preschools which have closed down. That is for the lower age group children. It's really pathetic to know about all this. It has put a lot of stress on self-financed institutions that are totally dependent on fees to run school operations. Many state governments have issued circulars to private institutions to refrain from collecting fees. We understand that there has been no doubt that an epidemic of this magnitude has added strain on all families and society, especially due to the slump in the economy, but keeping in mind that it is imperative to understand that the process of learning and educating our children cannot stop. We cannot stop it. It will continue and it has to continue. Now, education has not stopped, dear parents. Only the four walls of the classroom and the playgrounds, swimming pool, or whatever facilities were provided to your child in the education institution, wherever your child had joined, only those are missing. The four walls are missing. And the social gathering of your child along with his or her friends, that is missing. But they are interacting nowadays. Everybody is interacting with each other on a daily basis, using their mobile phones, using their laptops, or using any gadgets that they have. However, our digital platform are helping schools to take online classes to ensure that all our student folks and teachers are well equipped to this 21st century transformation and digital learning for a better digital India. In a way, teachers are connected with their students online so that the children don't miss their teachers. However, I don't understand that why parents are not paying the school fees. Are they taking the advantage of the situation? Or are they thinking that my child is spending time at home, not going to the school, so why I should pay? They're not going to school physically, but mentally, they are preparing themselves by studying online, whatever and how much ever possible, maybe 2 hours in a day or 3 hours in a day. It wouldn't be continuous, like from morning 8:30 till 4 or whatever your school children's school timings were. Now, sitting at home last 2.5 months to 3 months, haven't we paid our maids, our servants, electricity bill, water bills, gas, mobile bills, internet bills, etc.? Government also announced, as one of my friends told me, that don't stop paying maids. Then why stop paying teachers? I think my friend, Miss Archana.
Rachna.
Miss Rachna is there along with me today. And when she will also throw light on what I have mentioned at present. I think Rachna can talk about this when you are talking. Rachna?
Yes.
Why resist and restrict school fees? Maybe you yourself might have gone through a tough situation financially. However, you have managed to pay your bills. You have managed to pay whatever you were committed to. But think about and pay for the education of your child. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Parabrahmam Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. We think Guru is the divine force. But are we respecting? Are we ensuring that our Guru is safe and sound? Please give a thought to that, parents and other people, society people. And also think about how will the teacher or the staff of an institution, of a school, okay, wherever your child was studying or child is studying, survive without being paid salaries for 3 to 4 months. Today, I went through a message sent by one of my friends. It stated that a hotel owner says, when there is no business, why should we retain so many staff? In the Army, Navy, Air Force, so many soldiers are recruited to keep our borders safe. If there are no wars, can we retrench them? Definitely no. We call our teachers as COVID-19 warriors. Don't we? Similarly, no one could anticipate that things will go this way. So tell me, people, do we remove our teachers from the jobs for none of their fault? Speaking frankly, many teachers have lost their jobs. Moving forward, e-education will be the standard practice for scores of educational institutions across the world. You mark on me, this would happen. It has already begun. We have been saying that only if we parents wholeheartedly understand the difficulties of all the teachers of our nation, we will survive our education. Just imagine teaching online without salary. Is that possible? Will you work without salary? Will you teach without salary? Yes, to some extent. But I, as a teacher, I don't think so. I can sustain myself without salary. They also have families to be taken care of. And if both husband and wife are working in the same institution, just imagine their plight. What will happen to the family? What will happen to the children? What will happen to the house? In case they're staying in a rental premises, what will happen? That is the most difficult part in our lives. How to resolve this fee issue is to be resolved only by our parents. Salary issues by the school managements. Touch a heart. And please do the needful. I personally feel not to victimize any other human being who serves the country for the betterment of our children. The teachers are there to ensure our children face the competitive world. Kindly do not take advantage of the situations. And there are so many ways, in fact, to ensure that all working staff in all institutions are paid without fail. I request parents to ensure they pay their children's school fees like any other payments which they are committed to. And I also request the managements to also ensure that their staff are paid at this difficult times. And I thank Kizar Ahmed, Mr. Kizar Ahmed from Kizar Technologies, to have given me this opportunity to spread this message to our society. Our society is very well understood, and we are all hand in hand together who look for a better India and a better nation. So our teachers are the backbone of our nation. Protect them, help them. Thank you. Over to Mrs. Archana.
Thank you, Lata ma'am, for giving me this platform and opportunity to speak. And thank you, Mr. Kizar Ahmed, for giving me this platform. Now, ma'am, as you have been discussing about the fee structure and the online education, I would like to throw some light. Firstly, I would like to say in Hindi, what do we call a sautela vyavahar? So the Indian government, the Indian government is doing that sautela vyavahar with the government school and non-government school, you can say. See, the government schools, they are getting all the salaries, DBT, everything on time. So the school authorities, the management, they are not having any pains to pay the salary to their staff. But what about the private budget schools or any private schools? Here, see, the management, they don't mind paying. But first, I would like to say government has been requesting from the beginning of the pandemic, pay your housekeeping staff, pay your maids. So are we educators even like we don't even have a value of a maid as well? Just if you put it in a straight word, we educators, right, as you rightly mentioned, that educators are known as guru. We are the nation builders who builds up all other professions in the world. And no provision has been made for the educators. It's very strange that maids have been asked to provide with the salary, but the educators, no, parents have been asked not to give the fees. Okay, so how if the parents do not give the fees, how do we pay our maids? You have taken into consideration the maids. You, and as you also rightly mentioned about the internet, free telephone, we all are asked to pay that, the basic essentials, you can say. But if you say the basic internet providers or the electricity providers, they are big brands. Okay, so can't they provide the services at this pandemic? Can't they provide their service for free? See, the lower strata is taken care of by the middle class. We have to pay them. The upper class is not asked to provide their services for free. Now the farmers, if you talk about the farmers, this is their reap time wherein they get the business for the whole year, they get the money collection now. If they don't pay, if you talk about North India, if they don't pay now, the whole amount is gone here and there, and then rest of the year they don't have money to pay. So government decision of refraining the parents from not paying is totally wrong. As parents, most of the parents are working from home. So if parents, while working from home online, and they can get their salary, why not teachers? The biggest mistake we as educators did is thinking for the future of our kids. See, this pandemic started around 15th March, 13th or 14th March in Mumbai. It was declared a lockdown from 15th March. So that was just about the final exam period to be started. So we as educators, we jumped. We were not technologically trained. See, the corporate professionals, they were trained. But we educators, we were not trained. But we jumped into whatever way we could. Like we started preparing sheets and sending photos, audios, WhatsApp video. Each one of them did the needful, what they could, so that we could provide the benefit to the kids. So when we started doing this without even thinking what is there on store for us, I think then it was not valued by the parents as well as the government. Now,
sure.
Now over the period of 3 months, when as I would again like to add up in Hindi, ki Modi ji ka sapna digital India. Three months, like we educators, we all became, most of us became tech savvy to take online classes, and we are on field to start the next academic session, and many of them have started. The government is sending no online classes because it affects no online screening because it is affecting the child. So now, ma'am, if no online screening, both the parents are working, where are the kids devoting their time? They are devoting their time playing PUBG for 4 to 5 hours or any other online games or TV. So are they not spending their time online? So what if we...
Very true.
If we as educators, we are giving the online training, then why it is demanded free? As a normal businessman, as a corporate person, we educators do have a family to support. And if everything is there that no online training, then stop any corporate business online, I would say. Make it total zero. Why there is a partiality? Why there is a partiality between a government school and a non-government school? And the government is not also making other educators aware of the policies which can help management pay their salaries. There are two policies. One is the Economic Revival Committee, wherein the Economic Revival Committee is a forum wherein the government provides loan to the school management so that the management can pay salary to the staff. Okay. And yes, against the receivable of fees, whenever the school will be receiving the fees in future, they will pay back the loan. So if this committee, Economic Revival Committee knowledge has been spread between all across the educators, wouldn't it be easy for the management to provide the salary if management is having money? See, this pandemic happened all of a sudden when the new academic session was about to start. And as management, see, nobody has a ready cash in hand left. See, whatever fees come, they have their future plans. So now this economic, the spread of knowledge of Economic Revival Committee would help the management to know and approach the government. And once they get the loan from the government, it will be easy for them. Another topic which I would like to add on is WBT, direct benefit for the students. This direct benefit transfer is meant for the students. So why not this be transferred directly in the child's or the parent's account? Now, if I as a parent, see, most of the government schools are having this benefit and the private schools are not even aware. The parents and the management are not even aware. So if the parents have the money in their hand, which is transferred as a direct benefit transfer, DBT, so will it not be easy for the parents to pay the fees? If I as a parent, I have DBT transferred in my account, will I not happily pay my fees? So why is the government not doing that direct DBT transfer facility? First question is that, and let the parents decide. Now the government, I don't know whether most of them are aware or not, government has also given a policy that the parents can leave the private schools without school leaving certificate and join a government school. So,
yes.
So without a school leaving certificate, if the school is leaving, what is the authentication and why the government is accepting that? So it is not fair on the part of government to treat government schools and private schools separately. And majority of us, we all are aware that many of the government schools, they are just on papers. If you go and check, they are physically, it doesn't exist also. Just to avail this direct benefit, DBT benefit and the salaries of the teacher, just a fictitious school is there. So I would just, to add on this, I would just request to go through these direct benefit transfer as well as Economic Revival Committee thing. And as well as we request the government that we all educators are trained to take online classes. If the kids, they are just watching TV and playing games, they are just wasting their time. And maybe few months down the line, a second standard child, if they are not doing online teaching, maybe they may go, be at a level of senior KG. You never know. See, so constant learning has been there. Yes, CBSE board has given a very, like recently I read a circular of CBSE board. A very good circular was there that teaching, online teaching on skills-based development. Yes, few subjects.
Of course, few, yes.
Yeah, so few subjects we agree. Few subjects we agree that online is not possible. But there, whichever subjects, whatever skill-based learning is there. Like I will tell you, like fun to learn is basically into co-curricular activities where we are developing on math skills. How to calculate faster than a calculator. So even if a child is not able to do the school maths, if we develop the calculation speed, as soon as the maths calculation power is not stopping, so as soon as the school reopens, the child will be much more brighter and faster. Same way, there are many programs which through skillful learning and the teachers, they are every day they are into innovative learning, how to make the kids make it a fun. And believe me, ma'am, when we log in at our class starts at 9:45. And when I log in at 9:30, I see 50, 60 students waiting before I log in. so that 15 minutes they could interact because, you know, see, at home they are just interacting with their parents. On Zoom, when they get a classroom in environment, they see each other face. And you will, if you want, I can share you a few videos. That is the best moment. You know, the feedback comes, ki, ma'am, we wait for this class the whole day, that when tomorrow morning we come and we meet. So, see, stopping online classes is not a solution. Asking the management just to pay. See, we have, all of us have heard 20 lakh crore amount has been, will be utilized by Modi ji for the benefit for this pandemic. Then why this education sector is left behind? And
To add to that point, let me just tell you, basically what happens in the big institutions, they collect the fees in the month of January, February only for the next year, coming year.
Right.
So what has happened is, before the pandemic only, most of the collection has already taken place.
Right.
Okay. And that is not being focused. There are very few schools who take a monthly payment.
Right. Most of them were taking 6 months also or minimum quarterly.
Yes, they take quarterly. Right. Quarterly fee has already been given for the coming academic. This is 2020-2021. Most of the fees has been already collected. And this, what I feel is the school management also is taking this as an advantage and trying not to pay the salaries to the teachers. And they should know as a school management, whatever you have spoken about DBT as well as the other
Economic Revival Committee.
So all this they should have known, because being in the management in a high position, they will know about all this, isn't it?
Ma'am, many of them are not aware because 1.5 months down the line, I have been interacting with so many like Pan India managements and principals, and many of them are not aware, and I'm just highlighting these points. Yeah. And you know, there are national presidents also who were not aware. So then the one who have already availed this benefit from economic revival, that management, you know, he told me we got 60 lakhs approximately, 15 lakhs per month was our teacher salary. And we availed 60 lakhs from the government on the basis of receivables. Nice.
Yeah, so, and they should, you know, support the others as well, and that they should talk about it. It's very good that you have brought this in, so that, you know, when we circulate this message, at least maximum number of people will get to know.
Ma'am, I will share this. I had at my talk show, I had the National Independent School Alliance president, who is 70,000 schools are registered with him, 70. And he was there for my talk show. Usually we have for 45 minutes, and that day we had 1 hour, 45 minutes. So I will send you a Facebook link. I will send you a Facebook link wherein you can you will know all the benefits, what the educators are facing through, and what he has been doing to fight for it with the government, and what can be done.
Right.
So I will just forward do hear that it is very, very informative, ma'am. And that is how I also came to know about it.
I know. Very good. And see, you know, like us being in the house for the nearly 2 to 3 months now, and we are working from home. We are there on the screen nearly 6 hours to 7 hours. And remaining 4 hours, we are learning through the, you know, mobile. We are watching, you know, WhatsApp. I mean, we are sending messages and we are reading, you know, so many messages. And 2 hours, we watch movies, two and a half hours on television. Then we learn cooking, you know, at being at home, you know, learn so many things through the digital media. And children, the skills, they can learn. They're learning. Many children are learning, you know, like you conduct your fun to learn through online. So they're learning that. And as you said, that math applications they're learning. Then they learn dancing. They learn singing. I recently saw, you know, some videos that my granddaughter, my sister's granddaughter, she was, you know, jumping and she was dancing and all. And they have learned so nicely, you know, on the...
Can you believe we have also done handwriting improvement online, and I would say pandemic has made us reach globally. We are teaching students from US and UK, and we are, believe me, 24/7, it is, as you said, 2 hours you are getting time to watch TV. I am not even getting time to do that, and believe me, we have done an online award ceremony too.
Oh,
we have done two series of award ceremonies. So, now it's 6 months, 3 months down the line. And we all are technically savvy now to teach the kids. So, let the parents decide whether they want, why the government is imposing no online. Are they stopping the kids to watch TV or play games? And why only on education? Why all the restrictions?
Very true. I support
all the restrictions on education.
Support for this cause, government has to decide and take a drastic decision on, you know, banning the online classes. They should not do that. And all the children should be given an opportunity and they should have the privilege of, you know, learning the modern technology as well as to, you know, upgrade themselves for the 21st century digital learning. So that's the best way. All the parents have to support as well as all the educators have to support. I wish everybody the very best, and let us take it in a positive way. The positiveness is very important in all of us. We have to walk hand in hand for this.
Right, ma'am, right.
And we both together, Rachna and Dr. Lata Murthy here, we both are giving you a great message. Be together and let's ensure that everybody is safe and sound.
With this, I would like to add Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas.
Very good. Let's give a round of applause. Very good. And all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Madam Rachna Bimrajka. And also thank you, Mr. Kizar Ahmed, for this opportunity. And I wish everybody the best of luck. Kindly ensure that all our teachers, teaching fraternity, are safe and they are happy. If they are happy, our children are happy.
Right, ma'am, right. Yes.
Thank you.